Hello, good morning to all teachers and my dear friends. Today I will try to explain Physics Chapter 9, Force and Law of Motion's topic, Law of Conservation of Momentum. To understand Law of Conservation of Momentum, we will first understand momentum or linear momentum. The linear momentum of a particle of an object that has mass m and moving with the velocity v is defined to be as a product of mass and velocity, where momentum is denoted by p, mass is denoted by m, and velocity is denoted by v. So it is represented as p is equal to mv. The SI unit of momentum is kg into meter per second, and CGS unit of momentum is gram into centimeter per second. Momentum of an object is directly proportional to mass and velocity. Now, what do you mean by conservation? The principle by which the total value of physical quantity or parameter remains constant in a system which is not subject to external influence. Let us understand this through an example. The second and third law of motion lead to an important result, the law of conservation of momentum.
So let us understand this through an example of gun.
As you have now seen the practical, when the bullet is fired off the gun, according to the Newton's third law, the force on the bullet by the gun is F, and the force of the gun by the bullet is minus F. Two forces act for the common interval of time. According to the Newton's second law, force F can be written as F is equal to delta P upon T, where the delta P represents change in momentum of an object. Or we can say delta P is equal to force into time. This means that F into T is change in momentum of bullet, and minus F into T is a change in momentum of gun. Since initially both are at rest, so that change in momentum equals to final momentum for each. Let PB be the momentum of bullet after firing, and PG is the recoil momentum of the gun. Then PB is equal to F into T is our first equation, and PG is equal to minus F into T is our second equation. Adding first and second equation, we get PB plus PG is equal to 0. But initial moment of the system is also 0. This means that initial moment equals to final moment, so that total momentum is conserved. This fact is known as law of conservation of momentum, according to the which when the net external force on a system of object is zero, total momentum of the system remains constant. Now let us consider this as a ball A and this as a ball B. This ball is having a mass MA and this ball is having a mass MB, traveling in a straight line in the same direction, velocity UA and UB respectively. No other unbalanced force is acting on them. Let UA is greater than UB. Both the balls will collide each other. The collision, which has last for the time t, ball A exert the force of FBA on ball B. Ball B exert the force FAB on ball A. VA and VB are the velocity of two balls A and B after collision. Respectively, then initial momentum ball A is equal to MA into UA, and final momentum of the ball is equal to MA into VA. Same as in the ball B, the initial momentum of ball B is MB into UB, and the final momentum of ball B is equal to mb into vb. According to the Newton's third law, force FBA is exerted by ball A on ball B. This is the action force FAB exerted by ball B on ball A, which is the reaction force which must be equal and opposite to each other. This FBA is equal to minus FAB. BA equals to MB into VB minus UB upon T, and minus FAB equals to minus MA into VA minus UA upon T. Now TT get cancelled out and we get MB into VB minus UB is equals to minus MA into VA minus UA. Can say that MB into VB minus MB into UB equals to minus MA into VA plus MA into UA. If we shift minus to the opposite side and plus to the another side, we get MB into VB plus MA into VA equals to MB into UB plus MA into UA. It represents total final momentum and it represents total initial momentum. So we conclude that momentum is equals to total initial momentum. The law of conservation of motion. For today, thank you and have a nice day.